Trade and Investment Promotion Organization of Japanese Government, named JETRO. So in this occasion, I'd like to mention 2 points. First, the globalization of Japanese company based on the statistic of trade FDI of Japan. Second, okay, this is the base point of our activity of JETRO. Second, what has JETRO been doing to promote inclusive trade in Japan? That this case, I think, will help you a further discussion in inclusive trade. Okay, in this slide, you can see that there is a big change in the trade of globalization of Japanese companies after the financial crisis in 2008. As you see in this slide, export from Japan has not returned to the level before the financial crisis 2008. FDI from Japan temporarily declined after the financial crisis, but has exceeded the level before the crisis since 2013. So FDI is becoming more important for Japanese companies to expand globally. Well, I calculated the ratio of export versus income derived from FDI. That is the sum of direct invest income and charges for the use of intellectual property in the balance of payment statistics. Last one includes the fee of technical and management support of parent company to their foreign affiliate. Well, income derived FDI is almost one-fourth of export in first 8 months of this year. Well, this slide, I like to exemplify export and the FDI of Japanese oat manufacturing, symbol of globalization of Japanese companies. I calculate the ratio of overseas production versus export. There was a linkage between the ratio and the exchange rate before 2013. Well, conventionally, expanding export ratio, strong yen, expanding overseas production ratio. However, since 2013, the overseas production ratio has been expanding despite the weak yen. I can say this trend as a mouth of a crocodile. Local production for local consumption, this is a strategy of globalization of Japanese auto industry. Minister of Economy and Trade and Industry conduct annual research on activities of Japanese companies which are foreign affiliated. One of the questions is, what is important point to decide FDI? The latest data is fiscal 2015. Comparing this latest data and the data for 10 years ago, the purpose of reduction of labor cost declined. The other hand, looking for the local market expanding, also for looking for neighboring third countries is expanding. So utilization is FTA by the affiliate of Japanese companies in ASEAN countries is active, as you see in this slide. I'd like to mention that FTAs are crucial for the globalization of Japanese companies. Well, second point I'd like to mention, what has JETRO been doing to promote inclusive trade in Japan? I would like to approach this from three perspectives. The first is SME. The second for the agriculture and the forestry and fishery industries. And the third for local region. Each of three groups tend to be left behind in globalization. JETRO take the following specific measures. Let me begin with SME. Last fiscal year, we launched the Consortium of New Export Nations as a prioritized activities in Japan. In Japan, there are numerous small and medium-sized enterprises which cannot benefit from globalization due to a lack of experience and know-how in overseas and overseas business and limited human resources. This is true even for many that possess excellent products and cutting-edge technologies. What is the most effective way to solve this problem? Obviously, it is provide well-experienced human resources to such SMEs. Where are such human resources in Japan? They are abundant in large companies like General Trading Company and manufacturers. If this match between the supply and demand for human resources is solved, then so will be the problem. JETRO is providing hands-on support to SMEs taking on the challenge of overseas market through the dispatch of 500 experts once hired from large companies. Although JETRO has a network of 45 domestic offices, they are not enough to handle requests and inquiries from 3 million SMEs in Japan. So we support including more than 1,000 support organizations like Chamber of Commerce and Industry and local bank. These organizations have joined us by providing one-stop service to such SMEs. We have already supported over 6,000 companies over the year and a half since the program started. And in considering methods to secure and expand opportunity for the SME to facilitate internet trade, utilization of cross-border income is also effective. Second point is about promote of export agriculture, forestry, and fishery product in Japan. That is inclusive trade part two of our JETRO's activity. And part three, this is about local region. SME exists in every corner of Japan. Agriculture is the same. Supporting SME and overseas business of agriculture leads to the development of rural areas. We also promote to attract foreign direct investment into local regions. Finally, I would like to stress and repeat the key to inclusive trade also in Japan is human resources. JETRO dispatch personnel for SMEs to take part in internship with overseas companies. Last year, we have sent 80 personnel to 16 countries such as Vietnam, India, Indonesia. We also invite personnel from overseas to Japan to let them take part in internship here. This year, we invited 122 personnel from Vietnam, China, Indonesia, and 11 other countries. Well, I'd like to repeat again, the key factor in inclusive trade is human resources, even in Japan. Thank you very much.